Hello and welcome to my creative space. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer and I want to take you into some editing. So we've got this really fun image to look at today, and there are a few kind of interesting things about believability that we're going to talk about in relation to surrealism. Because a lot of times when you hear the word surrealism, you tend to think of like things that couldn't really happen. Anything could occur in the picture. It can just be totally nonsensical. And to a degree, that's true. You know, surrealism is that pushback against reality, but it is also very much based in reality because we have to have a touchstone so that we understand the context in which this surrealism is happening. And that's what I love about the challenge of surrealism, is making it weird enough that you're brought out of your comfort zone, but grounded enough that you can at least start to analyze it from some point that you understand. So let's look at this edit where I have replaced my head and instead inserted flowers. Totally normal. Let's take a look. So here I'm going to, we've got the top of our layers, let's find the bottom. This is how it started. Very ladylike. I've got my remote in my mouth because, you know, when you're a self-portrait artist, you do what you can. But in this case, I knew for a fact that I wouldn't have a head in the final picture. So I just held it in my mouth because it didn't matter. And here I've gotten rid of the background and my head by just painting a color that was already in the background all around. I've added more skirt on for better flow because it's so beautiful. And that's one of the things that we need to talk about today, is the importance of movement in an image. Not every image, this won't apply to so many different things, but in my type of work where it's almost like a still image from a movie, movement is so important. And it creates believability too, like this was really happening. This is the most important step. So let's zoom in and just really take a look at this particular part where, and I can even see that I didn't totally erase it, so let's do that. Where we've added the neck in, and this neck is vital because if we left it like this, it would be two-dimensional. Clearly, this was not a 3D thing happening. It looks like it was sort of drawn in. There's no back to the neck, and so either it fell down, which doesn't seem likely, or we have to photograph it separately. So I photographed myself in this dress and then erased my head and neck right out of the middle section there, just erased it right out. And then I actually took a separate picture holding the dress up with the neck so that you could see the back rim of the neck. And then that is what I edited in here. So we've got that, we're darkening the whole image. Let me zoom out for you so we can see what we've got going on. So we've darkened the image. And then I decided that I wanted an even bigger frame. So I shrunk myself by making the canvas bigger and changed the color. This color was just too pink for me. I can't do it. I can't do the pinks. It's just not me. So I changed it to be red through the replace color tool that we've talked about. And then let's start to add in some roses. So I photographed these roses. I let them die first, photographed them, stuck them in the neck hole, and then started adding them around the image. And can you see how there's this motion blur? And I did that in camera, actually. I just dropped the roses and put them on a slower shutter speed on my camera and then allowed the natural motion blur to come through. I did this all on a black backdrop, so I just had to blend the roses in really easily. And it was quite simple to do compared to a lot of other edits that I'm used to. Expanding the frame even more, adding in more roses, and then just the finishing touches of adding in some texture, and done. And so that's how I created this image. And like I said, it's so important to have motion, to have this flow of energy in an image, from the motion that you might have in it to just the pose of the model being one that seems really integrated. So I'm not just standing there, but my arms are in the middle of something. What are they in the middle of? We don't know, but I'm not static, and that's so vital. So I hope that you enjoyed this image. It's really quite an easy one to tackle yourself. So if you're interested in trying something like this, get yourself a black backdrop. It could just be a black bedsheet, no big deal, that's great. hang it up, even if you have to duct tape it, that's what I do, and then make something with it in front of it and see how many props you can get in there or different colors that you might try and just see what feels right for you. So I hope you have a great time creating this week, and I'll see you soon. Bye.